though. Yeah, oh, called it. And called it. Let's go, baby.
Wonder where we're going. Let's see here. Zach rolled an 11. Not a bad roll. Beerus rolled a 5. That is not a good roll. What will Zach ban? He strikes Zach. Robos.
Okay, good choice, I'd say. Buggy versus a Hornet Bear.
I don't think anyone's gone Robos this entire tournament.
Robos is very quick to ban.
Yeah, seems like it.
Strikes High Rise and Flower. Probably going to basic, yep. Exactly.
Hornet has shown up in almost like every set this I feel like. So I can see why, because Hornet on Robos is like kind of a cluster.
It's really good. So I don't... Yeah, I mean, Beerus... well, no. In general, Hornet accomplishes what just about anything you want it to do. Oh.
Beerus went to the left, straight left, instead of going to a corner. That's what the... I think stopping for. Yeah. Yeah, that's the new rules. You have to go to a corner, or at least aim towards one. Some of the starting positions, you can't reach a corner.
You get close enough.
Yeah, it switches Zach.
Everybody's so lame. Just... Everybody mashes out of RoboCube.
Yeah.
Let's go freeze.
Oh.
Gets it by another one. Great charge. Gets him out of his face. I don't know if I agree with that wake up bees though.
Oh, the switch to splash.
He went for the double sniper, raw. Oh, his sniper barely hit first.
There's very heavy counter changing going on right now. But that glide is proving really effective.
Thank you, Fire, for the host. Interesting trade. Hey, Beerus is going to switch into his 180. I don't know if that's a great call, but he gets a good amount of damage off of it. I think he wants to switch back.
Honestly, yeah.
Well, he's got to switch back now.
But I guess the glider way. Zach has been having a lot of really good trades with that one.
Zach's landing a fair amount of freezes, but he's not getting anything off of them.
Yeah, it's kind of hard unless you're close enough to hit with the ground glider.
Yeah, I don't really understand why freeze is on this build. Oh, and he almost died from it, as I say that.
It's because the counter to glider is to dash straight at you, the person using it, and freeze is like a big pillar that kind of stops you from doing that. It's actually a pretty good... combo, I think.
It's just not... Yeah, I mean... He wasn't able to, like, get really anything off of it, but I guess if it was supposed to be only defensive, then I guess so.
It's going to be interesting if Zach chooses to change, because the splash was not effective, but it is also stopping the stun pick from Beerus.
Yeah, he only went... splash because of the double blind, like, secret parts at the beginning. Mm-hmm. Only reason he went splash. Otherwise, knowing Zach, he probably would have went, like, bubble or something stupid, so.
It'd be interesting to see, Zach hates needle, but, like, that's what I would be going as my second.
No Man's Land, Robos, High Rise. He says no, No Man's Land. That was an easy, easy bait read by Zach. Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
Easiest Robos bait read. Right. He wasn't going to go to High Rise. Nobody thought he was going to go to High Rise. It was either going to be No Man's Land or Robos. You have to pick the stage, essentially.
Pick the poison.
Keeping the splash. Geo trap. I would not use Titan. Oops. I know that for sure. Maybe think about Delta, I think. Oh, that's interesting. Gemini.
Once again, proving that Zach can do whatever the hell he wants.
Okay, so this, I think this is interesting, because the main counter to Hornet is the ability to change elevation really quickly. Oh, and he's switching to stun. So the glider pick is like almost useless now, but splash does well versus stun.
This is going to be very volatile.
The only thing is Zach sacrificed a ton of damage by picking Gemini, so we're going to have to see how it goes.
What utility do you think is going to try to get out of Gemini?
I think he just likes being able to box people in with it. Oh, but the...
Oh!
Yeah, he gets out of there.
Oh.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, this is really hard to dodge, but the high jump is certainly helping him. Oh, good charge.
Beerus has got to pick his battles, and he's not doing super well about it. He wins his matchup, especially on paper, but he's not picking his battles very well.
Yeah, he's playing really safe with the Hornet, and I don't know if that's what he's supposed to do.
Not on Robos.
Yeah.
If it was like nature, see, maybe, but it's Robos.
Hmm. Yeah, when he dashes in, he tends to hit Zach, but he's not been dashing in as much. Of course, yeah, he is low now.
Gets the change. Okay, I get it. Good little stun there.
Oh.
Great little combo string there by Zach. Ooh, he wanted the melee. He wanted to end it. He wanted the melee bees. Called out the charge. Oh my goodness.
And the switch, we'll get it. He got the switch.
Yeah. Just defensive play there.
Press the attack. Yeah.
That won't kill.
Yeah, but now he's got it. Oh, this is big. Oh, he can, Zach can win it here. Boy, he doesn't have enough damage. Oh, that's interesting. He's got to play really safe now. Because he needs that charge. The switch.
Oh my goodness.
Over. Oh no.
Oh, he almost. Oh. I don't think even with like an insane godlike mash, Beerus could have gotten out of that.
Yeah, that was a really dangerous right at the end when Zach switched to glider. Because if Beerus was able to get stunned, that was just dead.
It was the game. Yeah.
That was a very tense match. It's gonna be interesting to see if Beerus changes, because glider actually was not as effective as I thought it would be.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to. Maybe?
I would change from glider with Zach, honestly.
Yeah, glider doesn't accomplish anything, but looks like he's not going to.
Okay, I see. He wants more damage, because one of the problems with splash is it was effective, but he wasn't getting a lot of damage when he was using Gemini, so he's increasing the, like, ability of that splash.
I'm surprised he didn't throw on standard for Robos.
Yeah, I mean, it's a matter of when he thinks he's going to be throwing his bomb, because if he thinks he's going to be spending a lot of time in the air, then Crescent P would be a bit better. Ooh, he's got out of it.
Gets just enough hits down at the splash. Yeah, Beerus has to get out of that corner when he approaches like that. The corners on one side of Robo's room are way, way more physically demanding to get out of than the other ones, just because of the little corner wall.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, the Dow canceled double.
Good charge. Okay, catches the dash back though.
Yeah, he got Zach got caught in that wall.
Ah, he dashes right into it. Oh, and he gets the dash out! Oh my goodness. Yeah, he puts himself into the corner.
I would bomb again. Yeah.
Gets just enough bees.
Ooh!
Wow.
The double charge cancel.
Oh, that's interesting. I didn't even notice he had faint F on that build.
Oh wow. Charge
if Zach gets an unlucky down cancel here, he could potentially be killed.
Oh my god. That barely didn't hit. That's a lot of damage. That's gonna kill. Oh! He just gets the charge out. He should live. Oh, and he hits the Wyvern.
That was a tense matches.
Feels bad, man. Jeez.
On that Robo's room pick, it'd be very interesting if I know Beerus has a needle chicken heart, and after the stun was stopped by Splash, it would have been interesting if he went needle chicken heart.